So our goal is to find all the zeros of this polynomial. How many zeros is it going to have?
Three. How can you tell? That's the highest power. That's the degree of the polynomial. Okay.
I don't know that it's factorable, so therefore we're going to our graphing calculators to find the zeros. Did you find any zeros?
Negative five.
Anybody agree?
Yes, I'd agree.
Negative five. Okay. So we know from our calculator. We found x equals negative 5 is one of our zeros. There's a couple other zeros, but they're long decimals, aren't they? Okay. We want to know what they are exactly. All right. We don't want the rounded decimals. We want to know what they are exactly. So here's what I would do in this instance. Because x equals negative 5 is a 0, can you tell me what one of the factors of this polynomial is? The factors. The factor, not the 0, the factor.
X plus 5.
X plus 5. Remember that from yesterday? The factor would be like a linear factor where it's x plus or minus whatever the 0, or it's going to be x minus whatever the 0 is. Okay? So x minus negative 5 then would be x plus 5. So if we know that x plus 5 is a factor, what could I do to figure out the other factors? Synthetic division, divide. Okay? Just think about this. The number 1098. Do you just know the factors of those off the top of your head?
No,
but do you know a number that goes into 1,098?
It's even.
So 2, right? Okay. So how could you figure out some of the other factors? Divide by 2 and see where you're at, right?
One question.
Yeah.
How do you define the table on this?
Yeah. How do you find the table?
Like, how did you look at the table?
So I see the graph button in the top right. Right above it, it says table. So go second, table. And then you can kind of look through there, and you should notice that when x is negative 5, the y value is 0. Yes or no, Tana?
Yes.
You found it?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I like using the table. I think it's a little bit faster.
Yeah.
Okay. So because I know x plus 5 is a factor, I'm going to divide this polynomial by x plus 5. I'm going to use synthetic division. If you remember long division, you really like it, go for it, okay, but I'm going to use synthetic division. To use synthetic division, if I'm going to divide by the factor x plus 5, what number goes in the little box in the top left-hand corner? Negative 5. It's always the 0 itself, whatever the 0 is, that's the number that will go in the little box. What numbers go here to the right?
The coefficients.
Very good. So 1, 3, negative 14, negative 20. First step, drop the first coefficient down, so 1. What do I do with that 1?
Multiply it by negative 5.
Multiply by negative 5, put that underneath the 3, add them together and repeat the process, right? And you better get 0 because otherwise you did it wrong. We know that negative 5 is a 0, so it's going to go into it evenly. So that would be x squared minus 2x minus 4, correct? Any questions on that? So when I divided the original polynomial by x plus 5, this is what I got. Okay? So I could rewrite this polynomial now as a multiplication of two factors. One of my factors is x plus 5, and that is my other factor. Because what's going to happen if I take x plus 5 and I multiply it by this factor down here? I'll get back to where I started. Yeah? Okay. So I'm going to rewrite it. X plus 5, and then it was x squared.
Minus 2x.
So all I've done so far is I've factored this polynomial, right? I found one of the zeros on my graphing calculator. Because I found a zero, I knew one of the factors. To find my other factor, I did synthetic division to reach that other factor. Now, to find my zeros, what do I need to do with each factor? Set them equal to zero and solve, right? Which obviously we know this one already. You know, x plus 5 equals 0, so x equals negative 5. We knew that right from the get-go from our calculators. But how do you do this? How do you solve this quadratic equation? Factor it if possible. If it were factorable, you would have found all the zeros on the calculator. It's not factorable. Completing the square or quadratic formula. X equals maybe b plus or minus square root.
Which one's the best one? Which one should we do?
I'm not a completing the square fan.
Yeah, I don't like it.
I already forgot what you told me yesterday about it, so.
I'm going to go ahead and use the quadratic formula.
Oh, no, is this the...
X equals the opposite of b.
Negative.
2.
So 2. Plus or minus the square root. B squared. So 4, right? Minus 4 times my A value times my C value. I won't do that all in my head. That's going to be a lot of stuff for you guys to keep track of. So I just wrote, I did the B squared part in my head, okay? But then minus 4 times A times C. I'm just going to write that out for us. Okay? All over
2A.
Which 2 times 1 is 2. Okay? All right, then we'll simplify. 4 minus, that's a negative 16, right?
Yep.
So 4 minus negative 16 is?
20.
That's negative 16, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right, somebody said wait. So, we good? Mm-hmm. Simplify the square to 20. Break it down.
2 square root 5.
So 2 square root 5 is what that's going to be. And then I'm going to separate the fractions. So 2 over 2 plus or minus 2 root 5 over 2. I'm just separating the fractions. And then simplify. X equals what? 2 over 2 is 1. 2 root 5 over 2 would just be? Root 5. So 1 plus or minus root 5. There are the other two zeros. 1 plus the square root of 5 and 1 minus the square root of 5. Those would be the other two zeros of this polynomial.
I'm confused on 4. We went through like the whole process and we got like the square root of negative 5. So wouldn't it be 5i?
Or I root 5, maybe?
I
root 5. Let me finish this one here first and I'll go to that one here. What questions do you guys have on this one? So let me summarize our process here. Okay, let me summarize it so it's clear. We knew from the polynomial there would be 3 zeros. I couldn't factor it. So therefore, I went to my calculator. Unfortunately, my calculator only showed me 1 nice one. Okay? Since I only have 1 nice zero, use that zero and do synthetic division to get you down to a quadratic equation, quadratic factor. Once you get into a quadratic factor, you can set that factor equal to zero and solve it by either completing the square or using the quadratic formula to get your other two zeros.
Are the other two real zeros?
They are real in this case. They're just not rational numbers or nice numbers. When I say nice numbers, you understand what I mean. They're numbers that are decimals that go on forever. They never repeat. They're irrational numbers. Okay? Your calculator will find them and round it to about 8 or 9 decimal places on your, you know, if you calculate the zero. Notice, these will always come in pairs too. just like the I's will always come in pairs, these will always come in pairs as well, because again, what are we solving? A quadratic. And anytime you solve a quadratic, you're going to have a plus minus in there. So those are always going to come in pairs. Those irrational zeros will always come in pairs. The I's, the imaginary ones will always come in pairs. All right? The only problem that could be longer than one of these is if I gave you an x to the fourth and you could find two of them on your calculator. So you'd have to do synthetic division twice to get down to a quadratic and then use the quadratic formula to find the last two.
What do you mean,
okay?
Do synthetic twice?
Well, if you start with x to the fourth power and you do synthetic division once, what will your answer have for its highest power? X to the third. Okay? We can't really solve an x to the third one. There's no cubic equation like there's a quadratic formula. So then we'd have to take that cubic polynomial and do synthetic division again with the other zero, the second zero that we found on our calculator.
Does it matter which zero you do first?
It would not matter which zero you would do first. It would, like, you know that 48 is divided by 2 and 3. Doesn't matter if you divide by 2 first and then 3, or 3 first and then 2, and you go to try and find your other factors. You'll get down to the same thing eventually. You'll get down to all the factors eventually. It doesn't matter the order that you do. Okay? But that's the only way I can make these problems longer, is if by forcing you to do synthetic division an extra time or two to get it down to a quadratic. But every time you're going to be able to get it down to a quadratic, and worst case scenario, use your quadratic formula to find the last two. Okay? Alright, so that was an example of one where you got one using your calculator, you found the other two by doing synthetic division, and then the quadratic formula. Alright, now you had a question on 4?
Not actually. My question's on 7 now.
Okay. What are our thoughts on this one?
Synthetic division didn't work.
Did you find a zero on the calculator?
Yep, it's one.
It's one, right? So one is a zero for sure. So then you tried synthetic division?
Yes.
Here's what you probably missed on the synthetic division part, and it's a common mistake. It happens a lot. When you do synthetic division, you need to account for all of the coefficients of the polynomial, starting with the highest power. So this has a 1x cubed, then it has a 0x squared, then it has a 0x, and then it has a negative 1. This is your setup for your synthetic division to this one, because it's like having a placeholder, you know, in long division. Because it's 1x cubed plus 0x squared plus 0x minus 1. You have to account for all the terms from the highest power down to the constant. It's like having that placeholder when you do long division. If the number can't go into something, you still got to put a 0 there before you go into, okay, well, if 7 can't go into 3, then try it into 35 or whatever it is. You know, you gotta take that into account. So here's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So that'd be 1x squared plus 1x plus 1. There's your quadratic now, and you're going to have to do the quadratic formula to get the last two zeros. Yep.
So we're able to throw those x's in there still, even though, like, because, like, all the other ones we have each term and stuff, we're still able to throw those x's in there?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's exactly.
Yeah. Like, that made sense, because in the original we have each term. But like, even in one where it's just, like, the x cubed minus one, we can still throw those x's in there as if there's a, like, b zero.
Yes. Because I would compare it to... something like this. There clearly are no 10s in 704, right? There's 4 1s and 700s. There are no 10s. Mm-hmm. But when I divide, this goes into 7 one time, 6 goes into 10 one time, 6 goes into 44. So there's going to be a 10 in my answer. Even though there weren't any 10s to begin with. Because kind of we had to essentially borrow if you really go way back. But I mean, just because there's not a certain one there, but when you do all the division, I would say, well, sometimes then you can end up with tens because you might have to borrow to use some and things like that. That's the closest I could say to try and compare it to. But you know, if I say x squared, well, I have x squared, I have 1x squared, I have 0 x's. All of a sudden I need to add x's, and then I'll have some. So just because we don't write x doesn't mean it won't exist in the problem at all.
Okay.
All right. Any others looking at this worksheet right now? That would be good to probably have on video that you've gotten stuck on.
We did 3 wrong, too.
You did 3 incorrectly?
Yes.
So on 3... one of the zeros, based on the work that I showed there, one of the zeros must have been a 2, right?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So we had x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 6 equals 0. Mm-hmm. And on your calculator, we found x equals 2 to be one of the zeros. Then we did synthetic division, and we got what? X squared plus 3. So that would tell me then that I have, my factors would be x minus 2 and x squared plus 3.
Yeah.
Right? This is after doing synthetic division. So you had this, you did the synthetic division with the 2 in the box, and you got a 1, a 0, and a 3. It was 1x squared plus 0x plus 3, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now, to solve, to find my zeros, what do I do with each factor?
Set it equal to
0. Set it equal to 0. So this one we already know is 2. If I set x squared plus 3 equal to 0, how would you solve that one? I wouldn't use the quadratic formula on this one. You certainly could, but I wouldn't use it. I'd just subtract 3. And then what?
Square root.
Square root. So x would equal plus or minus. Now, when you square root a negative 3... you just bring the I out to the front and it'd be I root 3.
Yeah, that's what we did.
There's no
that's
way
we
got
from
that
one.
No.
We left with the I under the root.
Oh, okay.
That's why.
So
that's
just a
we didn't
thing.
Do that's all.
Let me show you how that kind of works. If I said to simplify the square root of negative 8, you need to think of the square root of negative 8 as the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 8. Think of it as two separate square roots. Well, what is the square root of negative 1? I. So now I have I times the square root of 8. Now, can we simplify the square root of 8? Yes, it simplifies to 2 root 2. So you can bring a 2 out to the front. So my final answer would be 2i root 2. Okay? And if I were solving an equation, it would be plus or minus 2i root 2, because they would be coming in pairs. Alright. Any others on this?
I was confused on 9.
Yeah, does it actually cross the x-axis?
What was going on?
It does, I believe, at 2. Number 9.
Yeah.
I would enjoy doing that. If at all possible.
Did you find, was 2 a 0 on number 9?
I don't
I know exactly. I remember working on it last night, and I got, like, super
I have negative you, and then I don't
know. No, check your table. There's one. At two.
Oh, yeah, that's why.
The other ones must not be nice. They must be irrational numbers.
So it doesn't actually...
It might hit. I think it does hit. I think it does. Based on the answers, it looks like it's going to hit. But it doesn't happen on an integer, so it must happen on some long decimal, so it must be an irrational number.
Okay.
But I can clearly tell from your table that it hits at two.
Yeah, two is for sure. I got confused because it, like, touches the line at the bottom, but,
what
like,
is
it doesn't
one
at the same
multi
time.
Two
that's the next one that I want to get to.
Loop.
Okay.
So all you'll do on nine is do your synthetic division with two.
Okay.
Because you found that. That'll get you down to a quadratic. And then you'll be able to either use square roots or a quadratic formula to finish.
Okay.
That's on number nine. So it'll be no different than the ones we've been doing so far. If you can't find other nice ones off your table of values, just use the one that you did find, get it down to a quadratic, and then you, yes, yep. All right?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, everybody look at 13. Everybody look at 13. Okay, this is, I haven't talked about this yet, so this is a new one. X to the 6th minus x to the 4th minus x squared plus 1 equals 0. Go ahead and graph that. Once you have it graphed, I'd like to take a sneak peek at it.
Here.
So, roughly this is what it looks like, okay? Now, a lot of times in the graphs, the function will start below it or above it. It'll cross the x-axis, go above it, then cross it again, then cross it again, and maybe cross it again. Okay? When that happens, wherever it crosses the x-axis, that is definitely a zero of the function. Okay? Yes. Think about this parabola right here, y equals x minus 3 cubed. Hey, this is a pretty good concept. Faith, do you need help on the calculator?
No, Maggie's. There we go. It was just zoomed in.
If you don't like the zoom, if you hit the zoom button followed by the number 6, it'll get you back to a negative 10 to 10, negative 10 to 10, like what, you know, kind of like what I would call its standard formatting. That's the quick way to do it. Okay? All right, so here's a pretty important concept, guys. So I want you to think about the graph of y equals x minus 3 quantity squared. Parabola moved 3 to the right, correct? Okay. So it'll look something like that. Okay. If I were to FOIL that out, what power would the x have on it?
6.
Looking right here. If I were to FOIL this out, take x minus 3 times x minus 3, what power would the x have on it?
X cubed.
Squared, right? Yep, squared. So therefore, this has to have how many zeros?
Two.
Two of them. Okay? Well, look at the graph. It goes down, touches the x-axis, and comes back up. Okay? So it looks like it only has one zero, right? Actually, it has two zeros. It's just the same number twice. Because if I were to write this as factors, wouldn't it be x minus 3 and x minus 3? Yeah. These are your two factors. So what are the two zeros? 3 and 3. 3 is a zero twice. 3 is a zero multiple times. Which really is just saying x minus 3 is a factor multiple times. It'd be similar to saying... Let's take the number 12. 2 is a factor twice in the number 12. You'd have 2 squared, right? Okay? Anytime a graph comes down and touches the x-axis and then goes back up, or if it's below it, touches it and comes back down, there's a pretty good chance that wherever it hits right there, that value is a 0 multiple times. So in other words, you might have to do synthetic division multiple times with that x value, with that 0. Because it's like saying there are more than one factors that are identical. Okay? So now, knowing that, that sometimes zeros can be zeros multiple times, when you graph this and you look at your table of values, what values of x result in this being a 0 of the polynomial? What did you notice? -1 was a 0, and +1 was a 0. Everybody with me on that?
Yep.
From your graphing calculator, you found that -1 was a 0, and +1 was a 0? Well, that only looks like 2 zeros, right? Well, clearly, there have to be 6 of them. Well, I'm not going to give you a problem where you can only find 2 zeros and then you have to try and solve some quartic equation. Because if I do synthetic division with those 2 zeros, that'll only get it down to an x to the 4th power, right? There's got to be a way to get it down to an x squared. Well, the way is going to be you're going to have to use synthetic division multiple times with a 1, multiple times with a -1. However many times it works, I would just usually go with 2 to start, okay? But you're going to do it multiple times to see if it's a 0 multiple times. Okay? So here's what I mean by that. We know that 1 is a 0, so let's go ahead and do synthetic division with a 1. 1, 0, -1, 0, -1, 0, 1. Right? Because 1x to the 6th plus 0x to the 5th minus x to the 4th plus x to the or plus 0x to the 3rd minus 1x squared plus 0x plus 1. I got a placeholder, right? Do synthetic division. 1, 1. I'm adding here, right? Yeah, you always add. Yep. So this only gets me down, though, to x to the 5th power, right? Yes? This would be 1x to the 5th plus 1x to the 4th plus 0x to the 3rd plus 0x squared minus 1x minus 1?
Yep.
Okay? We need to keep going. We need to get this down to an x squared. Okay? Do we know another 0? -1. All right. Well, let's use -1 with these values. Okay? I'm going to kind of combine this to save room. I'm going to use -1 with these values that I just got. Okay, drop the 1, -1, 0. I'm going to get us out of doing synthetic division a couple more times on this one. What are we at right now? 1, x to the 4th, minus 1. That's factorable,
yeah.
Which is awesome. I don't have to do synthetic division anymore. Okay. If you didn't recognize that as being factorable, you could do synthetic division again 2 more times. I would use a 1 again, and I would use a -1 again. Okay. However, because right now I have x to the 4th minus 1, I know my factors of this polynomial are x minus 1, x plus 1, and x to the 4th minus 1. What questions do you have on that? We know that 1 was a 0, so x minus 1 is a factor. We know that negative 1 is a 0, so x plus 1 is a factor. After I got done dividing by these two factors, what was left over? X to the 4th minus 1. Good explanation, bad explanation? Give me some feedback.
Good.
We're okay?
Yeah.
Now it's awesome because x to the 4th minus 1 is factorable. Okay? X plus 1, x minus 1, and I said x to the 4th minus 1. That is the difference of two perfect squares. Just like if I had x squared minus 49, what are the factors for x squared minus 49? X plus 7 and x minus 7. This is the difference of two perfect squares. What are the two factors of x to the 4th minus 1? X squared minus 1 and x squared plus 1. Guess what? More perfect squares. What could this break down to?
X plus 1, x minus 1.
X plus 1, x minus 1. I got x plus 1, x minus 1, x squared plus 1, and then another x plus 1, x minus 1.
You could put one on this, like, on the test. That's bound for me to make a small mistake.
Now, can you guys see how negative 1 is a 0 multiple times?
Yes.
Negative 1 is a 0 here and a 0 here. Positive 1 is a 0 here, positive 1 is a 0 there.
So we just have that last.
You just have this last one, set it equal to 0. X squared equals negative 1, so x equals plus or minus I. Okay? So if I needed to list the zeros of this function, here's how I would list them. Here are my zeros. Plus or minus I. The positive I is a zero, negative I is a zero. Negative 1 is a zero twice, so we write negative 1 with a multiplicity of 2. And positive 1 with a multiplicity of 2. Okay? We'll work more on multiplicity probably tomorrow.